In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you, with your spirit. My dear brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and ask God to fill us with His mercy and love. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts, in my words, in what I have done, in what I have failed to do, to my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, our Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me, the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you. We bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who give constant increase to your church by new offspring, grant that your servants may hold fast in their lives to the sacrament they have received in faith. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. On the day of Pentecost, Peter stood up with the 11, raised his voice and proclaimed, "You who are Jews, indeed all of you staying in Jerusalem, let this be known to you, and listen to my words. You who are children of Israel, hear these words. Jesus the Nazarene was a man commended to you by God with mighty deeds, wonders, and signs, which God worked through him in your midst, as you yourselves know. This man, delivered up by the set plan and foreknowledge of God, you killed using lawless men to crucify him. But God raised him up, releasing him from the throes of death, because it was impossible for him to be held by it. For David said of him, 'I saw the Lord ever before me, with him with him at my right hand, I shall not be disturbed. Therefore, my heart has been glad, and my tongue has exulted. My flesh too will dwell in hope. Because you will not abandon my soul to the nether world, nor will you suffer your Holy One to see corruption. You have made known to me the paths of life. You will fill me with joy in your presence. My brothers, one can confidently say to you about the patriarch David that he died and was buried, and his tomb is in our midst to this day. But since he was a prophet and knew that God had sworn an oath to him that he would set one of his descendants upon this throne, he foresaw and spoke of the resurrection of the Christ, that neither was he abandoned to the netherworld, nor did his flesh see corruption. God raised this Jesus, of this we are all witnesses. Exalted at the right hand of God, he poured forth the promise of the Holy Spirit that he received from the Father, as you both see and hear. The word of the Lord. The responsorial psalm. Your response shall be, keep me safe, O God, you are my hope. Keep me, O God, for in you I take refuge. I say to the Lord, my Lord are you, O Lord, my allotted portion and my cup. You it is who hold fast my lot. Keep me safe, O God, you are my hope. I bless the Lord who counsels me. Even in the night my heart exhorts me. I set the Lord ever before me. With him at my right hand, I shall not be disturbed. Keep me safe, O my God, you are my hope. Therefore my heart is glad, my soul rejoices. My body too abides in confidence, because you will not abandon my soul to the netherworld, nor will you suffer your faithful one to undergo corruption. Keep me safe, O God, you are my hope. You will show me the path to life, fullness of joys in your presence, delights at your right hand forever. Keep me safe, O God, you are my hope. Alleluia, alleluia. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us be glad and rejoice in it. Alleluia, alleluia. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Mary Magdalene and the other Mary went away quickly from the tomb, fearful yet overjoyed, and ran to announce the news to his disciples. And behold, Jesus met them on their way and greeted them. They approached her, embraced his feet, and did him homage. Then Jesus said to them, "Do not be afraid. Go tell my brothers to go to Galilee, to go to Galilee, and there they will see me." While they were going, some of the guard went into the city and told the chief priests all that had happened. The chief priests assembled with the elders and took counsel. Then they gave a large sum of money to the soldiers, telling them, "You are to say, his disciples came by night and stole him while we were asleep. And if this gets to the ears of the governor, We will satisfy him and keep you out of trouble. The soldiers took the money and did as they were instructed. And this story has circulated among the Jews to the present day. The Gospel of the Lord. In today's Gospel reading, we have seen two kinds of responses to the good news of Jesus' resurrection, and two kinds of journeys we have seen in today's Gospel reading. The one journey of the women who ran to Jesus' disciples to announce the good news that Jesus is alive. And the second journey is of the soldiers. They went to the chief priests and elders to announce the same news, to inform them the same news. Jesus is risen. And there were a different response from the chief priests and the soldiers and the elders. They wanted to cover that good news, and they made up a story out of that good news to cover that good news. Jesus' body was stolen by his disciples. So two journeys and two contrasting responses we have seen in today's Gospel reading. So the women, they announced the triumph of life over death, triumph of grace over sin, the victory of love over hate. But the chief priests and the elders, they cannot digest that story, and they were not able to embrace the truth of the resurrection. My dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, let us reflect on in which side we are. Are we with the women, or are we with the chief priests and the elders? Are we with the good news, or are we with a story, a made-up story, to cover that, to reject that good news? So we are called to be the people of Easter. We are called to be the people of good news. And we have to witness that good news. We have to give witness to that good news by our own lives, by shining, by becoming a shining light, by proclaiming through our lives, Jesus is risen and he is alive. He is alive in our midst. We need to proclaim that by our truthful lives, by our dedicated services, by our committed lives. So let us ask God to send his Spirit, as he sent the Spirit upon his disciples, to strengthen them. Ask him to strengthen us by the power of his Spirit to be the real witnesses of his, real witnesses of the good news of Easter. And let us be the people of Easter. Amen. This Eucharist celebrates the life we have with the Lord Jesus and each other. Let us present our needs to the Father who protects us and consecrates us in truth. For the renewal of prophecy and compassion in the Church, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For peoples and nations torn apart by war, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For the hungry, the homeless, and the abandoned, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For all who seek God, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For those who sit and listen at the feet of the Lord, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For those who wish they could sit at the feet of the Lord and listen, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For unending peace and blessing for those who have died, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. And let us offer our own personal intentions and prayers to our loving God. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. Almighty, ever living God, eternal health of believers, hear our prayers for your servants who are sick with coronavirus. Grant them, we implore you, your merciful help, so that with their health restored, they may give you thanks in the midst of your church. To our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer, fruit of the earth, the work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God forever. By the mystery of this water and wine, we come to share the divinity of Jesus Christ, who humbled himself to share our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer. Fruit of the vine, work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Blessed be God forever. With humble spirit and contrite heart, may we accept the sacrifice this day, pleasing to you, Lord God. Wash me, Lord, my iniquities and cleanse me. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be accepted to God the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Accept graciously, O Lord, we pray, the offerings of your peoples, that renewed by confession of your name and by baptism, they may attain unending happiness. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. Lift up your heart. We lift them up to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and just. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord. But in this time, above all, to love you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb, who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he has destroyed our death, and by rising, restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people excels in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Felipe Esteves our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also, brothers and sisters, who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who are pleased to you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs in eternal life, and may praise and glorify through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command, formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that with the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to the apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always, and with your spirit. Let us offer it as a sign of peace. May this mingling of the body and blood of Jesus Christ bring eternal life to us who receive it. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, and us peace. May the receiving and body and blood of Jesus Christ not bring me to judgment and damnation, but through your Lord and mercy, be for me protection of mind and body. Amen. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to a supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you enter my room, but only say the word, my soul shall be healed. I invite you to join me for the prayer of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come, at least spiritually, into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Let us pray. May the grace of this Paschal sacrament abound in our minds, we pray, O Lord, and make those you have set on the way of eternal salvation worthy of your gifts. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go in peace, glorifying God by your lives. Thanks be to God. Have a blessed day.